We've done collaborations with other artists along these lines where we would do a limited edition version of their standard product. In this specific case, it was multiple dreams coming true on different levels.
Welcome to the studio.
All right.
Paul McCartney, he always takes everything as a license to experiment. McCartney 1, a record that was really confusing to people at the time. McCartney 2, a record that was just flat out outrageously outlandish to people at the time. He is always thinking about right now. He's an artist who is committed to spontaneity. Stagnation is not his thing. I was so shocked that Paul McCartney made a new record in quarantine. And on a second level, I was shocked that it was framed as, you know, continuing the tradition of McCartney 1 and 2. Who else in history would be capable of stringing those three albums over 50 years? What artist, you know, in any medium?
When I started discussing this with Paul's manager, he said, let's destroy the old to make the new.
For McCartney 3 to be this principle of creative destruction, it very much brings the whole project full circle.
Taking the old music of Paul McCartney's first two solo homemade records and integrating them into the third one is just a really unique, interesting concept.
We've never done that before. There's no mouse control or digital button to press that magically makes this happen. So it is essentially done by hand with a lot of experimentation.
Blood, sweat, and tears are in the record from the recording studio to the pressing plant.
Paul McCartney famously pays attention to every tiny detail of the record, physically and emotionally, how we consume it.
After the label is dinked out, then it goes into a grinder. Those pellets are heated to make sort of a plastic rope. That rope then gets inserted into the mold of the press. And that's where the grooves get pressed into the plastic and make your record. Then it gets inspected visually. Then they hand that record off to our audio QC. They listen to the record from start to finish to make sure that there isn't any imperfection. And then sleeved and then off to packaging.
We concentrate very much on the number 3. It's his third album, We're Third Man.
333 vinyl records. That's exactly where Jack White's mind and Paul McCartney's mind intersect.
Could it be more perfect than that?
Calling it McCartney 3 is such a bold statement. Paul self-consciously put this in the tradition of two classic albums. In many ways, McCartney 1, 2, and 3, they are really three pillars that fulfill his goals artistically, creatively, musically, culturally. They're Paul McCartney responding to what the moment demands of him. Life brought the trilogy out of him.
I hope that philosophical idea of something new growing out of something old, a metaphorical rebirth as well as a physical rebirth for this vinyl, I hope that comes through to people. Maybe you can't hear it, but it's there.